Students, we have talked about the two methods of data, primary data collection in the previous class. The first was interview and the second was observation method. Now, in today's class, I will be talking about the third method of primary data collection, which is the method of questionnaires. Now, questionnaire can be used to collect both qualitative data as well as quantitative data depending upon the nature of questions. Okay, so what is a questionnaire? A questionnaire is a set of questions that you have created to be asked to various respondents, and you sent these questionnaires to them and they will answer the questions. Okay, so whenever you are writing a question, you will either use open-ended questions or you can use closed-ended questions. Now, what are open-ended questions? Open-ended questions are those wherein you can describe things, and closed-ended questions are those in which you will provide options for ticking. Okay, so in open-ended questions, what the researcher can do is ask a topic and then they can give lot of answers. Okay, so these open-ended questions are generally used for qualitative data collection because they are describing things. Okay, now in closed-ended question, what you're doing, you are giving a certain set of options which are multiple choice answers, and you have to analyze them using quantitative methods. Fine. Okay, now see, what are the various advantages of a questionnaire? Okay, the first is you have a very high speed of data collection. You can easily collect data if you are doing it through questionnaire method. Okay, the second benefit is it is of low or no cost requirements. Okay, third is there is a higher level of objectivity, means you are very specific while you are asking questions through a questionnaire. Then what can be the disadvantages of a questionnaire method of data collection? See, first is if you are asking descriptive questions or open-ended question, then the research respondents can answer whatever they feel like. Okay, now also respondents may not properly read the questions and answer the questions. Okay, now there are various types of questionnaires that can be used in case of this method. First is a computer questionnaire. Now, what is a computer questionnaire? In this, the respondents are asked to answer the questionnaires which is sent to them through the computer or through mails. Okay, so questionnaire is sent through email to the respondents. The advantage is that it is very inexpensive because you have to send it via mail only. Then you have your time efficiency because you just require a few seconds to send. Okay, so and there is no pressure on respondents. They can respond whenever they want to and whenever they have time. Okay, the major problem is that sometimes the respondents may not answer to your questionnaire and may ignore your questionnaire if you are sending through computer. Okay, the second method in which you can use a questionnaire is a telephone questionnaire. Now, what you do is you will call the potential respondents with the aim of getting answers to your questions. Now, what is the advantage? Again, it can be done in a short time period. Okay, but the major disadvantage is it is quite expensive. Also, people do not generally feel comfortable to answer to questions which are asked over the phone. So, it is difficult to get a sample group to answer the questions over phone. Now, the third way in which questionnaire can be used is a in-house survey. Now, what is an in-house survey? You will visit the houses of the respondents or workplace, and then you will give them or ask them question to fill the questionnaires. Now, in this, the advantage is that the respondents give more focus and there is no chance of your questionnaire being unanswered. Okay, but the disadvantage is it is very time consuming first, then it is very expensive. Third, the researcher may not wish to have the interview in the house or workplace. Okay, now the fourth way in which you can use a questionnaire is through email. We can email the questionnaire to the through mail. Okay, so you can send them through post in an envelope, and in this you will get accurate answers because the respondent can answer the question in spare time. But the disadvantage is that it is very expensive. It will take a lot of time because first you will send the post to the respondents and then they will fill it up and send it back. So it will take a lot of time generally. Okay. Now, a questionnaire includes different types of questions. So, what are the various types of questions that can be used in an interview? First, I told you open-ended questions. What are open-ended questions? These are the descriptive type questions in which the respondent has a liberty to answer in any words that he chooses. The second is MCQ or multiple choice questions. It is also a closed-ended questionnaire. In this, the respondents will be given a set of answers from which they have to choose. Okay, so if there are too many answers, then the questionnaire will become confusing and boring, and then the respondents will not like to answer. Okay, the third is dichotomous questions. So what are dichotomous questions? In which we have only two options, for example yes or no. Okay, so these are the easiest form of questions that you can ask in a questionnaire. Okay, now fourth are called scaling questions, or you can also call them ranking questions. So what happens in this method is the researcher can present an option to respondents to rank the available answers on a scale, okay, say from 1 to 10. So if you want to know the rating of something, you can tell that how happy are you with this product. So such questions are called scaling questions, and these questions can also be used in case of an questionnaire. Okay, see, on questionnaire we have a detailed study in unit 4. The entire unit 4 is based on questionnaire. So in this unit I have told you only the basics of the questionnaire. When I teach you unit 4, I will be telling in detail everything about the questionnaire, its types, its functionings, when to use it, when not to use it. Okay, so this is just a brief description about a questionnaire, and in the next unit, where in unit 4, I will take up questionnaire again with a detailed description. Now we are left with one more method of primary data collection called schedules, which I will take up in the next class. Meanwhile, students, please go through these videos in order to understand the topic well, and I am also attaching notes along with it, so go through them as well. Thank you.